Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor. Under the former's banner, Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, the duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi, and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India, and the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million, box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography handled by Baba Azmi took place in Srinagar, Mumbai, and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Bonnie Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant is a local journalist who eventually become friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sinha, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun entered his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mugambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mugambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphan who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the other orphans are all captured by the Mugambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mugambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mugambo threatens to kill two children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mugambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mugambo activates four intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mugambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonates on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the children escape. Mugambo's fortress is destroyed and Mugambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sinha, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roop Chand, Amrish Puri as Mugambo, Ajan Srivastav as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Kalender, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal, and Mantra. Saleem Javed, a duo consisting of Saleem Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Salim Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language film from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8 lakh 50,000, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Kalender, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by IBNE Safi's Jasusi Duniya, following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty. It was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devkan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Dasgupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, The Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kate Nahi Katte was shot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop-motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi, and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India. And the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million. Box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography, handled by Baba Azmi, took place in Srinagar, Mumbai, and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards, Best Film Bonnie Kapoor, Best Director Kapoor, Best Actor Anil Kapoor, and Best Actress Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely film superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sina, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun enters his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mogambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mogambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphans who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the other orphans are all captured by the Mogambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mogambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mogambo threatens to kill 2 children. But because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mogambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mogambo activates 4 intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him. The 2 fight and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mogambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonate on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Calendar and the children escape. Mogambo's fortress is destroyed and Mogambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sina, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mogambo, Ajan Srivastava as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Calendar, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal and Mantra. Salim Javed, a duo consisting of Salim Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Salim Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language film from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8,50,000, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Calendar, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by IBNE Safi's Jasusi Duniya, following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty. It was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devkan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, the tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was shot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Boni Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises. Starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, the duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohoni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Boni Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali. म्यूजिक वॉज गिवन बाय लक्ष्मीकांत प्यारेलाल, प्रोडक्शन कंपनी नरसिम्हा एंटरप्राइजेस. द फिल्म वॉज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय सुजाता फिल्म एंड इट वॉज रिलीज्ड ऑन द डेट 25 मई 1987. रनिंग टाइम वॉज 179 मिनट्स. कंट्री इंडिया एंड द लैंग्वेज इन विच द फिल्म वॉज रिलीज्ड वॉज हिंदी. बजट 38 मिलियन. बॉक्स ऑफिस रिकॉर्ड्स 100 मिलियन. आफ्टर वॉचिंग हिज प्रीवियस डायरेक्टोरियल वेंचर मासूम, अ 1983 फिल्म ड्रामा अबाउट चिल्ड्रेन, बोनी कपूर अप्रोच्ड कपूर टू मेक अनदर फिल्म विद सिमिलर थीम्स. प्रिंसिपल फोटोग्राफी हैंडल्ड बाय बाबा आजमी टुक प्लेस इन श्रीनगर मुंबई एंड अदर लोकेशंस इन इंडिया स्टार्टिंग इन जुलाई 1985 एंड फिनिश्ड आफ्टर 350 डेज. लक्ष्मीकांत प्यारेलाल कंपोज द साउंड ट्रैक वाइल अख्तर रोड द लिरिक्स. आफ्टर फिल्मिंग एंडेड बमन भोंसले एंड गुरुदत्त शिराली jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Boni Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannada as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sinha, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun enters his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue. styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mugambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mugambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphan who stays at Arun house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender and the other orphans are all captured by the Mugambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mugambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mugambo threatens to kill two children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mugambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mugambo activates four intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mugambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonate on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Kalender and the children escape. Mugambo's fortress is destroyed and Mugambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sina, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mugambo, Ajan Srivastava as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Kalender, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal and Mantra. Saleem Javed, a duo consisting of Saleem Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found a copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Saleem Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language film from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8 lakh 50 thousand, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Kalender, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by IBNE Safi's Jasusi Duniya. Following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty, it was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Viru Devgan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, the Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was a shoot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua, as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel, The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudat Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India, and the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million. Box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography handled by Baba Azmi took place in Srinagar, Mumbai and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudat Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Bonnie Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannada as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sinha, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun enters his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mugambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mugambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphans who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the other orphans are all captured by the Mugambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mugambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mugambo threatens to kill two children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mugambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mugambo activates four intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mugambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonates on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the children escape. Mugambo's fortress is destroyed and Mugambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpach Man Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sinha, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mugambo, Ajan Srivastava as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Kalender, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal, and Mantra. Saleem Javed, a duo consisting of Saleem Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found a copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Bonnie Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Saleem Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language film from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8,50,000, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Kalender, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by Ibn-e Safi's Jasoosi Duniya, following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty. It was reported that he received a salary of 10 million. Making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devkan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, the Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was a shoot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop-motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India, and the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million. Box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography handled by Baba Azmi took place in Srinagar, Mumbai and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Boni Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely film superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sina, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun entered his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mogambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mogambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphan who stays at Arun house, find the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender and the other orphans are all captured by the Mogambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mogambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mogambo threatens to kill 2 children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mogambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mogambo activates 4 intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mogambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonates on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Calendar and the children escape. Mogambo's fortress is destroyed and Mogambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sina, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mogambo, Ajan Srivastav as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Calendar, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal and Mantra. Salim Javed, a duo consisting of Salim Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Salim Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language films from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8,50,000, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portray calendar, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by IBNE Safi's Jasusi Duniya, following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty. It was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devkan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, The Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was shot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop-motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel, The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, Best Facts and Reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Boni Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and fall in love with her. द फिल्म वॉज डायरेक्टेड बाय शेखर कपूर, रिटन बाय सलीम जावेद, प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय बोनी कपूर एंड सुरेंद्र कपूर, स्टारिंग अनिल कपूर, श्रीदेवी एंड अमरीश पुरी, सिनेमेटोग्राफी बाय बाबा आजमी. द फिल्म वॉज एडिटेड बाय वमन भोंसले एंड गुरुदत्त शिराली. म्यूजिक वॉज गिवन बाय लक्ष्मीकांत प्यारेलाल. प्रोडक्शन कंपनी नरसिम्हा एंटरप्राइजेस. द फिल्म वॉज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय सुजाता फिल्म्स एंड इट वॉज रिलीज्ड ऑन द डेट 25 मई 1987. रनिंग टाइम वॉज 179 मिनट्स. कंट्री इंडिया एंड द लैंग्वेज इन विच द फिल्म वॉज रिलीज्ड वॉज हिंदी. बजट 38 मिलियन. बॉक्स ऑफिस रिकॉर्ड्स 100 मिलियन. आफ्टर वॉचिंग हिज प्रीवियस डायरेक्टोरियल वेंचर मासूम, a 1983 film drama about children, Boni Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography handled by Baba Azmi took place in Srinagar, Mumbai and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film Boni Kapoor, Best Director Kapoor, Best Actor Anil Kapoor, and Best Actress Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase Mogambo Khush Hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sina, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun entered his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mugambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mugambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphans who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the other orphans are all captured by the Mugambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mugambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mugambo threatens to kill two children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mugambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mugambo activates four intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mugambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonates on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the children escape. Mugambo's fortress is destroyed and Mugambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sina, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mugambo, Ajan Srivastava as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Kalender, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal, and Mantra. Salim Javed, a duo consisting of Salim Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Salim Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language film from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8 lakh 50 thousand, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Kalender, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word Kalender while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by IBNE Safi's Jasusi Duniya. Following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty, it was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devkan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene, featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles, was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, the Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was shot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Guru Dutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mugambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop-motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Guru Dutt Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India, and the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million. Box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography, handled by Baba Azmi, took place in Srinagar, Mumbai, and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Guru Dutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Bonnie Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rethme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mugambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings preparatory by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sinha, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun enters his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mogambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mogambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphans who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the other orphans are all captured by the Mogambo's henchman as prime suspect and brought for interrogation before him. Mogambo tortures them so he can reveal Mr. India's identity and the location of the device. Arun eventually admits to this when Mogambo threatens to kill two children, but because Arun has lost the device by accidentally dropping it somewhere during the capture, he cannot become invisible to prove himself. Mogambo sends them into the dungeons temporarily. However, they are able to escape by stealing the keys from a guard. Meanwhile, Mogambo activates four intercontinental ballistic missiles which are poised to destroy all of India. Arun confronts him, the two fight, and Arun gains the upper hand. But as he is about to stop the missile, Mogambo warns that everyone present will die if Arun succeeds. Nevertheless, Arun deactivates the launch and the missile detonates on the launch pad. Arun, Seema, Kalender, and the children escape. Mogambo's fortress is destroyed and Mogambo dies. When we discuss the cast, Anil Kapoor as Arun Verma, Sridevi as Seema Sohoni, Anu Kapoor as Mr. Gorton, Seema's newspaper editor, Ramesh Dio as police inspector, Gurpachman Singh as Captain Zoro, Azit Vachni as Teza, Ashok Kumar as Professor Sinha, Bob Christo as Mr. Walcott, Harish Patel as Roopchand, Amrish Puri as Mogambo, Ajan Srivastava as Baburam, Satish Kaushik as Kalender, Ahmed Khan as an orphan, Aftab Shivdasni as Jugal, Yunus Parvez as Maniklal, Sharad Saxena as Daga. When we discuss its production and development of the film, after watching Shekhar Kapoor's film, family film Masoom 1983, producer Boni Kapoor approached him to make another film with theme related to children. Kapoor immediately accepted the offer and received 10,000 salary. Kapoor had been a fan of comic books and always wanted to make a superhero film. He had written several comic books that received international acclaim: Devi, Snake Woman, The Warlord, The Omega Crystal, and Mantra. Salim Javed, a duo consisting of Salim Khan and Javed Akhtar, was signed to write the story and screenplay for 70,000. Several publications claim they took inspiration from the science fiction film Mr. X, released in 1957, and Mr. X in Bombay, released in 1964. But Kapoor denied these reports, saying that he never found copy of the film. Kapoor wrote the dialogue in Hindustani, a mix of Hindi and Urdu. Boni Kapoor co-produced the film alongside his father Surinder Kapoor under the Narsimha Enterprises banner. And casting, Anil Kapoor and Sridevi were cast as the main protagonist, Amrish Puri as the principal antagonist. Anil Kapoor play Arun, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who rent a large old house to help 10 orphans. The role of Salim Javed was specifically written for Rajesh Khanna, but later they asked Amitabh Bachchan to play it when they found Khanna did not suit the role. Bachchan, however, felt that the concept of an invisible man would overshadow his performance, saying, "The real hero of the film is an invisible character, so why do you need me?" The duo took this as an insult, and at a Holi festival held a few days later, Akhtar told him that neither he nor Khan would work with him again. In fact, Khan never said that and blamed Akhtar for his misunderstanding. This resulted in their split, making Mr. India their final collaboration. In an interview with Rediff.com, Anil Kapoor admitted that he added his own style to the role so the audience would not realize it was going to be done by Bachchan. Sridevi was given the role of Seema, a journalist who became a friend and then fall in love with Arun. After watching several of her Tamil language films from 1970s, Boni Kapoor cast his future wife in the film and went to Madras, present-day Chennai, to meet her. Kapoor said he cast Sridevi solely because she represented every Indian male dreams, with her baby face and luscious body. Having established herself as one of the most popular actress, she charged the producer 8 lakh to 8,50,000, while her mother Rajeshwari Iyengar, who often accompanied her, asked for 1 million. Kapoor actually paid her a higher amount, around 1.1 million. This was the first film Kapoor had shot with the actress. Satish Kaushik, who also served as an associate director alongside Raj Kanwar, portrayed Kalender, Arun's assistant. When asked by the Hindu about his character's name, he explained him originated from his father's, a Delhi-based salesman dealer who liked to insert the word calendar while talking. After hearing the story from his father, Kaushik suggested the idea to Kapoor, who liked it immediately. Anu Kapoor features as Gotende, Sridevi's newspaper editor. He was paid 5,000. Amrish Puri was cast as Mogambo, a character that was inspired by Ibn-e Safi's Jasusi Duniya. Following his meeting with Boni Kapoor and Kapoor while shooting the 1987 thriller Loha in Ooty, it was reported that he received a salary of 10 million, making him the highest paid Indian villain actor of all the time. The part was initially offered to Anupam Kher. However, after his screen test, the crew believed he looked more funny than ferocious. According to Kaushik, Puri was chosen later because of his menacing persona. Kapoor asked him to imagine he is playing a Shakespearean character to 9-year-old kid while portraying Mogambo and filming. Baba Azmi began the principal photography of Mr. India on July 6 in 1985. In later years, Kapoor recalled it as terrible days for him and spoke of difficulties he and the film's cast and crew member faced in this period. According to Kapoor, it had to be shot slowly because of all the trick photography and technical innovation it entailed. Saroj Khan and Veeru Devgan were the choreographer and action director respectively, while Bijon Das Gupta finished the production design. A big set was built at the RK studio for the Mogambo sequences. The film opening scene featuring a group of governmental officers lightening from heavily armored vehicles was shot at the Sophia College for Women in Mumbai. The sequences where Sridevi dresses up as Charlie Chaplin's on-screen character, the Tramp, took between 30 and 35 days to finish. In an interview in Filmfare's December 1992 issue, she called the sequences my all-time favorite and revealed that the film's crew loved her while she wore the costume. The song Kaate Nahi Katte was a shoot in Srinagar. Saroj Khan found it to be the most difficult song of her career and said she took 15 minutes to do the choreography, requiring her to create sensuous moments. Filming was finished after 350 days and Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali edited it. Kapoor asked them to cut several repeats of the line Mogambo Khush Hua as he felt it appeared too often in the film. Akhtar disagreed with the film, convincing him that the line would be popular with the audience. Peter Peria handled the special effects. He used mechanical effects to make Anil Kapoor's character invisible and stop-motion technique for his footprints. Hello friends, welcome to our channel The Film Dimension. Today we are here with the 1987 Hindi movie Mr. India, best facts and reviews. Let's start the video, but before starting, please subscribe our channel and do like our video. Mr. India is a 1987 Indian Hindi language superhero film directed by Shekhar Kapoor and produced jointly by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor under the former's banner Narsimha Enterprises, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri. The duo Saleem Javed wrote the screenplay and story, marking their last collaboration before their split. It focuses on Arun Verma, Anil Kapoor, a poor street violinist and philanthropist who receives a clocking device that grants him invisibility. While renting out his house to pay his debts, he meets the journalist Seema Sohoni, Sridevi, and falls in love with her. The film was directed by Shekhar Kapoor, written by Saleem Javed, produced by Bonnie Kapoor and Surinder Kapoor, starring Anil Kapoor, Sridevi and Amrish Puri, cinematography by Baba Azmi. The film was edited by Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali. Music was given by Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Production company Narsimha Enterprises. The film was distributed by Sujata Films and it was released on the date 25th May 1987. Running time was 179 minutes. Country India, and the language in which the film was released was Hindi. Budget 38 million. Box office records 100 million. After watching his previous directorial venture, Masoom, a 1983 film drama about children, Bonnie Kapoor approached Kapoor to make another film with similar themes. Principal photography handled by Baba Azmi took place in Srinagar, Mumbai and other locations in India, starting in July 1985 and finished after 350 days. Lakshmikant Pyarelal composed the soundtrack while Akhtar wrote the lyrics. After filming ended, Vaman Bhosle and Gurudutt Shirali jointly edited it. Peter Pereira completed the special effects. Mr. India was released on 25th May in 1987. It emerged as a commercial success and became the second highest grossing Indian film of the year, earning 100 million against a 38 million budget. It received widespread acclaim from contemporary and modern critics, with most of them appreciating the performances of Anil Kapoor and Sridevi. The film won several accolades, including 4 trophies at the First Star and Style Lux Awards: Best Film, Boni Kapoor; Best Director, Kapoor; Best Actor, Anil Kapoor; and Best Actress, Sridevi. In 2013, Sridevi was awarded the Special Award at the 58th Filmfare Awards. Mr. India was a breakthrough for its director and cast members and became a milestone in Hindi cinema for its rarely filmed superhero genre, which was followed by several Indian films in later years. It was remade in Tamil as N. Rathnin Rathme in 1989 and Kannad as Jai Karnataka in 1989. A 3D sequel titled Mr. India 2 was announced in 2011 but has not entered production. And when we discuss its plot, Mogambo is a criminal whose goal is to conquer India. From his hidden island, he monitors all the evil doings perpetrated by his henchmen. His catchphrase, Mogambo khush hua, Mogambo is pleased, and Hail Mogambo, used by his subordinates, shows his complete authority over his minions. On the other hand, Arun is a street violinist and philanthropist who rents a large old house to take care of 10 orphans with the help of Kalender. Arun is seldom able to make ends meet and owns many debts, so he decides to rent out the room on the first floor. Seema, his first tenant, is a local journalist who eventually becomes friend with everyone. Arun falls in love with her. He receives a mysterious letter from a family friend, Professor Sinha, which reveals that Arun's late father, who was a renowned scientist, had created a cloaking device that would make its user invisible. It still needed to be patented, and because Arun was the only son, it was his responsibility to complete the protocols and sign the paperwork for it. Arun saw this as an opportunity and immediately hatched a plan to get the device. With the directions in the letter and accompanied by his ward, Arun entered his father's old laboratory. When the device is activated, it makes the wearer invisible unless red light is focused on the wearer. Arun decides to keep it a secret. After a few months, as a tenant, Seema is invited to a lavish party hosted by an acquaintance, and she performs a song under the guise of a famous Hawaiian dancer who is unable to make it to party. After the performance, she is nearly killed by criminals who think she is a spy, but Arun comes to her rescue, styling himself as an invisible person and introducing himself to them as Mr. India. Seema subsequently falls for her rescuer. However, Arun keeps his identity as Mr. India secret for a few more months. One day, Arun uses the device to trick one of Mogambo's henchmen to foil his criminal plans. He reports the incident to his leader. Thereafter, Mogambo has bombs disguised as toy plant in public places. Tina, one of the orphans who stays at Arun's house, finds the trap and takes them, resulting in her death. Arun, Seema, Kalender.